Well, to our other top story, the rally for Vladdy. It's inspired by a story you saw first right here on 7 Action News.
Right now, hundreds of people gathered in front of the Spirit of Detroit protesting cuts in care they say are threatening the lives of 18,000 auto no-fault crash survivors. We broke the story of how Red Wings legend Vladimir Konstantinov is at risk of losing his life, preserving care due to the law change.
7 Action News reporter Kim Russell spoke to his old teammate Darren McCarty as he fights for a change. Kim, first and foremost, how is Vladdy?
With the help.
Detroit Red Wings legend Darren McCarty is known for getting results on the ice.
What do I mean that? A couple quick stories of Vladdy's toughness.
He's hoping to see results for accident survivors now by speaking out at the rally for Vladdy.
To me, this is an act of tyranny. You know, it really is against the people.
Michigan's auto no-fault reform was bipartisan. It passed the Republican-controlled legislature, and Governor Gretchen Whitmer signed it into law in 2019, saying it would save drivers money on insurance. It went into effect last summer, cutting the benefits paid for care of people with catastrophic car accident injuries by 45%. That's right, as inflation increased prices and the job market tightened, the funding for care was slashed 45%. This despite the fact there are billions of dollars in the Michigan Catastrophic Claims Association Fund. $400 per insured car in surplus money in the fund was sent to drivers in recent months. The cuts in benefits impacted people going forward and people who had already paid for catastrophic coverage in the past.
This is what you sold me. This is what I paid to. This is what I understand it to be. And then all of a sudden you go, oh, we're changing the rules. No.
McCarty says while Konstantinov has friends in high places with resources to help him, that isn't the answer. There are 18,000 catastrophically injured Michiganders losing established necessary care due to the reforms.
But forget about Vladdy. What about everybody else that isn't Vladdy, right? We're talking about one person. But in the whole scheme of things, if they take this away from him and everyone else, it means death. We're not throwing these people out. If I have anything way to help.
Now, Glenda, you asked, how is Vladdy? And I got to see him as he arrived here. He's doing well, out and about, independent, with the help of caregivers who provide assistance to him 24 hours a day. And that's what is at risk, that 24-hour round-the-clock care that he says gives him quality of life. Coming up on 7 Action News at 6, we'll talk about why Vladdy has care right now when some of the people who are cared for by the company that's providing him care had to be discharged. I'll tell you who's helping out and why it's not a permanent solution. Reporting live, Kim Russell, 7 Action News.
And they are still a team, still fighting together. Kim, thank you.